Greetings, everyone. Welcome to What's Going On, Episode 1, Facebook Censored. Today, we will talk about some new draconian laws that is sure to surface within the next couple of weeks or so. Let's get into it. We're here at this tech website where Facebook says Facebook is changing its terms of service and its users are not happy, and the terms will be effective October 1st, 2020, next month. And we're going to be talking about this and why this date is so important as we go over our list of events later on in the video to come. Now, all of this will be linked in the description below. We will not go over everything today, but what you need to know is Facebook is changing its terms of service. The new clause will allow it to remove content or restrict user access to avoid lawsuits or regulatory impact coming into effect as of October 1st. Now, what does this mean for us? This means basically more censorship. If they do not agree with what we are posting or what we are commenting on, they can basically restrict our access, remove our post, or simply cancel our membership with Facebook. They also say lawsuits. Facebook do not want to be responsible for lawsuits against anyone who's talking against the COVID-19. So very interesting and suspicious. So first they start off with saying the services that we provide. Our mission is to give people the power to build community and bring the world closer together. To help advance this mission, we provide the products and services described below to you. As we go further down, we start to notice some things that are very suspicious indeed. We're now at the fifth bullet point where it says right here, combat harmful conduct and protect and support our community. People will only build a community on Facebook if they feel safe. We employ dedicated teams around the world and develop advanced technical systems to detect the misuse of our products. Harmful conduct toward others and situations where we may be able to help, support, or protect our community. If we learn of such content or conduct like this, we will take appropriate actions. For example, offering help, removing content, removing or restricting access to certain features, disabling an account, or contacting law enforcement. We share data with other Facebook companies when we detect misuse or harmful conduct by someone using one of our products. There you have it. So what is harmful conduct to them, according to them? It could be that we're speaking against the vaccines, or it could be that we're speaking against abortions, or that we support gun rights, or whatever the case may be. It could be many other things. All of these things they can find inappropriate for their platform, and they can take appropriate action according to them by disabling, restricting, or contacting law enforcement. Many of us didn't see this coming when we signed up for Facebook, but we are at this point, ladies and gentlemen. It's up to us now to decide what we want to do with it. So again, we see the full-blown censorship that is unfolding right before us, and it's perfect timing because the next article that you're going to go over with me, you will understand that around the same time this law is being presented, the COVID-19 vaccine will be presented. And they don't want people to speak out against this. They want to basically brainwash us and keep us quiet while we're wearing our masks, you know, keep us quiet and separated from each other. They know that the vaccine is going to spread the disease more, and they don't want you warning your friends in other countries. They don't want you talking about it. So it's going to get very difficult the next months, and I do feel that this is the last month we have to freely speak about it, and it's up to you to download as many videos as you can to take note to what is happening. Okay, let's go down to number 4 where it says additional provisions, account suspension or terminations. We want Facebook to be a place where people feel welcome and safe to express themselves and share their thoughts and ideas. So my question is, why are they censoring our ideas? Why are we not free to express ourselves, our thoughts and ideas? This is something we need to think about. Now, let's continue. If we determine that you have clearly or seriously or repeatedly breached our terms or policies, including in particular our community standards, we may suspend or permanently disable access to your account. We may also suspend or disable your account if you repeatedly infringe other people's intellectual property rights or where we are required to do so for legal reasons. So once again, we see the step toward the one world government, the one world internet system, the new world order, a world where you will not be able to share truth, speak truth, or it will just be like their way, their narrative, or no way. Or they will simply deny you all the things you have become addicted to, Facebook, Instagram. You will not be able to access the platform unless you accept the policy. And a lot of people will sell their soul just to be able to use these platforms. Believe me that in people, it is so important now that we are really taking time to learn what is coming our way, you know, because it is no, you know, there's a time for dancing, there's a time for everything, but right now the world is about to change dramatically. And do you see where this is going? They're trying to obliterate the truth in any way, shape, or form. This is why it's important to get the truth out now and to learn and understand what is coming our way. They're looking to bring and usher in this new world order in any way, shape, or form that they can. And they're looking to do it faster than we are thinking and than what we're expecting, okay? Report from Stat News that says experts sees a chance for a COVID-19 vaccine approval this fall if it's done right. Now, why is this important? And how does this tie in with Facebook? Because again, Facebook do not want people exposing truth about vaccines. They do not want you sharing articles and information that could be against what they want you to believe in, okay? If you're sharing any kind of truth, then your friends and family see this and research into this, it's going to convince them not to take it, and Facebook doesn't want this, and neither does the New World Order. Why? Because they cannot control and potentially track you. Most people don't even understand and realize that they are implementing biotechnology in these vaccines and tracking devices. And to be honest, I don't think they understand what effect this will have on your body, how this will alter your behavior pattern. They don't know it. And to be honest, I don't even think they care about it. For them, it is important that they have total control over every human alive on the planet. And this is the plan. And your rights and everything will be taken away from you slowly but surely. We see this happening. And those that are paying attention understand that you need to be getting prepared for this. It is coming and time is short. It is so important that you understand what is coming, that you can prepare for this. And now we're here with legislation that is happening in United Kingdom that was presented a couple of days ago that is sure to spread around the world. Let's get into it. Coronavirus Act 2020, Chapter 7. This is a 360-page document, and for the sake of time, we will not discuss everything, but we will cover some important facts about this document. We are now at Schedule 21. Powers relating to potential infectious persons. Part 1, Overview and Interpretation. Section 51. Now, on the document itself is on page 233, and if you're following on the PDF, it's probably on 243. It's about a 10-page difference, but it goes over the overview and the interpretation of it. But we're going to scroll all the way down to 235 in the document because it goes over definitions where it talks about part 2, powers relating to potential infectious persons. Now remember, this is a documentation of United Kingdom, but you have to remember that this is a test in one region of the world, but if it is successful there, it could become global. Now, if there's a second potential lockdown, we have an idea of what is coming, okay? Now, we know this is the season for back to school, and not just back to school in America, but back to school for many parts of the world. Now, what this means is schools are getting ready and heavenly getting ready for COVID-19. Now, again, there's a lot of remote learning going on, but just pay attention to what this document is talking about when it comes to children specifically. Here we are at number 6. We're going to be reading from bullet point A through C. Powers to direct or remove persons to a place suitable for screening and assessments. doesn't this sound like these dystopian movies like The Fifth Wave and The Darkest Mind? This is very interesting and we need to pay attention to this. Prayerfully, I hope you are paying attention to this. Now, the public health officer may, subject to subject paragraph 3, direct the person to go immediately to a place specified in a direction which is suitable for screening and assessment. B, remove the person to a place suitable for screening and assessment. Or C, request the constable to remove the person to a place suitable for screening and assessment, and the constable may then do so. Tip, the constable may be the policeman. Next page, 236 within the document, and again what this is telling us is that the government now have the right to come to your house and remove you if they suspect that you have COVID, or if they suspect anything for illegal grounds. They can come test you or screen you or put you in some sort of camp or something. They have the right to do this. It's very important that you have your eyes open and you can understand that they have passed laws that they are able to do this. Okay, let's continue. A public health officer may exercise the power to confer by this paragraph in relation to a person only if the officer considers that it is necessary and proportionate to do so. You have nothing you can say. No matter the rights that you think you have no rights now. They decide if you go or not. That is a sham, it's a scam basically. It's just a way to get you into these camps, to force you to take these vaccinations, or whatever they plan to do with you. You know, it sounds crazy, but it is true. They can say that they suspect somebody was around you that have COVID-19 and you must take the vaccine. What will you do? Now on the next page, 237, it goes on to say a public officer may exercise a power conferred by paragraph 9 to 11 only if the officer considers it necessary and proportionate to do so, and that you can be there for a period not exceeding 48 hours, according to this document. Now, this is in England, of course, but we must be smart and wise to understand what could also be coming our way. So let's skip forward to page 239 and go down to powers exercisable after assessment. And this is very important. It says here, the paragraph applies where during a transmission control period, a person in England has been screened and assessed by a public health officer. A screening confirmed that the person is infected or contaminated with the coronavirus. A person in England has been assessed by a public health officer and the officer has reasonable grounds to suspect that a person is potentially infectious. Potentially infectious. This means that you do not have to have it, but they suspect only that you have it, and this is enough for them to detain you. Now, does this not sound like something that we've watched in many movies before? they have reasonable grounds to keep you based on their suspicions only, okay? Let's go down to 3D. Requirements under this paragraph may include requirements. D, to remain at a specified place, which may be a place suitable for screening and assessment for a specified period. E, to remain at a specific place in isolation from others for a specified period. Why do you think they're coming out with this kind of laws now? And then it says restrictions on a person under this paragraph may include restrictions for a specified period on a person's movement or travel within or outside the United Kingdom, the person's activities, including their work or business activities, the person's contacts with other persons or with other specified persons. Wow. So they not only have legal grounds to potentially take you away from your family and your friends and your children to take you to a different location, but now they can restrict you on where you go. They can tell you that you cannot leave the country because they suspect you have COVID, or they can say you cannot leave this specific area, a location that they relocate you to. This is very serious. You may be forced to take this vaccine. You see where this is going? Let's go down to 240, number 15.1. It says here, the period specified in relation to requirements referred to in the paragraph 14.3 D or E, or in relationship to restrictions under paragraph 14, may not exceed 14 days. So this is literally saying that the government can detain you for 14 days. That's what it says here. Only 14 days. But what happens when we go to 241, number 16, where it says a person is required to remain at a place under paragraph 14.3 D or E? The requirements may be enforced by a constable or public health officer removing the person to the place, by a constable or public health officer keeping a person at the place, or see a person absconds by a constable taking a person into custody and returning them to that place or another place a health officer may specify. Basically, it's saying if you don't comply, they can send you to prison, some concentration camp, some barge, prison barge, or wherever they feel that they want to send you. Now, this part of the document is very interesting when it comes to the children. In this document, it does talk about the children as well. On page 242, number 5, it says, where a power under the part of this schedule is exercisable in relationship to the child, but the child is not accompanied by an individual who has responsibility for the child, the person by whom the power is exercisable must, if practicable, contact the individual who has responsibility for the child before the power is exercised, or, if that is not practicable, take responsible steps after the power is being exercised to contact such an individual, such as to inform them of any exercise of the power in relation to the child. So basically, this lets you know that parents have to facilitate their children when it comes to if the child has to be removed or taken to another place for testing and screening and assessment. But what is the problem with this? You know, the school has started now and many places of the world are moving forward. But the problem is if there is another potential lockdown and your kids are at school, they can implement and they can, because of the threat, say that they are taking your child to another location to be screened, tested, maybe even vaccinated without your consent at the present time. Without you even accepting this, these are things we need to think about. It's very serious. Let's go over to the Children's Commissioner website, which is also a website in the United Kingdom, where it says, request an additional safeguard to ensure that children's rights and best interests are upheld during the coronavirus outbreak. Now, I won't go over everything here, but let's go down to a certain section where I would like us to discuss together. Detaining children on public health grounds. The act also introduces new powers to detain children on public health grounds for a period of up to 14 days. I agree that this may be necessary in order to prevent the further spread of disease. However, I am concerned that the act allows this to be done without consent from someone with responsibility for the child, and only requires reasonable steps to be taken to inform someone with responsibility of the detention. So once again, if your children are in school, and if there is legal ground according to the government, they can legally can come into the school to assess, to test, to vaccinate, or even detain the children, whatever they feel is necessary, with or without your consent. This is very serious that everyone should think about this. They say it's only 14 days, but who knows? They'll be testing and poking on your child without your consent, and they say there's nothing we can do about it. Now, a lot of people have noted that Melbourne, Australia, as well as New Zealand, is the test runs for the second potential lockdown and the lockdown worldwide. So we are here now at the Victoria Health and Human Services website, where it says stage 4 restrictions. Because if I'm not mistaken, Melbourne, Australia is under heavy restrictions. So let's start reading at the key points. It says, from 6 p.m. on Sunday, the 2nd of August, so as of last month, if you live in the metropolitan Melbourne, stage 4 restrictions apply. A curfew is in place between the hours of 8 p.m. and 5 a.m. This means you must be at home during these hours. The only reasons to leave home between 8 p.m. and 5 a.m. will be to work, medical care, or for caregiving. People, don't forget, this is all a smokescreen, you know. And I also want to mention that, you know, now that people are going back to school in America and over here in Europe, that during the time off and during the lockdown, a lot of these empty places, Walmarts and stores, could have been converted now into these camps, you know, because many places closed down and they've been remodeling in these places. So this is also something to think about, okay? And most of the things that we see happening in the world is, you know, they're always doing these tests before the real thing happens, you know? And most people don't understand that these people in power, they have to let us know what they're going to do before they do it. This is why all these subliminal messages are in films. They always let us know what is coming. And it seems to us like science fiction. But then some years down the line or some months down the line, we come to realize that it is our reality. They subliminally put the truth right in front of us. Now take a look at this cover to the right. What do you see? The first thing I personally notice is the clock on the wall. It is almost midnight, and no surprise with everything that's happening in the world. And then I look over and I see a comet or meteorite. And of course, I think they will blame it on global warming, but this is just an excuse. But those who have studied know that it is scriptural hailstones coming to punish a wicked planet. It is how it is, and knowledge is power. If you understand the plan, then you know exactly what's coming. Nothing new under the sun. And then let's go over here. We see something that appears to be a solar flare or a pandemic happening. And it looks as though they're potentially foreshadowing World War III as well. And I'm not saying that something will happen, but it is very wise to be aware of this time we're living in and to see all these signs that are around us. Yes.